Hello everyone, welcome back to Bio Vidyalaya. I hope you all are doing very well. In our previous videos, we have discussed about type 1, type 2 and type 3 hypersensitivity. In this video, we are going to discuss about type 4 hypersensitivity. So, let's start. Type 4 hypersensitivity. Type 4 hypersensitivity is also known as cell-mediated hypersensitivity or delayed type hypersensitivity. Why it is known as cell-mediated hypersensitivity? Because we know that in type 1, type 2 and type 3 reaction, there is antibodies are involved. But here, in type 4 reaction, antibodies are not involved. This is not antibody-mediated hypersensitivity. But this is cell-mediated response. The major cells involved in type 4 hypersensitivity is T cells or T helper cells. Here, specifically T cells are involved in the development of sensitivity. That's why this type 4 hypersensitivity is known as cell-mediated hypersensitivity. And it is also known as delayed type hypersensitivity because the tissue reaction usually occurs 24 to 48 hours after the antigen exposure. The reaction takes several days to develop. That's why this is also known as delayed type hypersensitivity. This response involves international T cells, monocytes and macrophages. I told you that the major cells involved in this type 4 hypersensitivity is T cells, mainly T helper cell 1. Apart from this T helper cell 1, T helper cell 17, CD8 plus cells or the cytotoxic T lymphocytes, macrophages, monocytes and dendritic cells are also involved. And it is caused when CD4 T helper cells recognize foreign antigen in a complex with MHC class 2 on the surface of antigen presenting cells. We know that on the surface of antigen presenting cells, MHC class 2 major histocompatibility complex is present. And this, our T helper cells identify only MHC class 2 presented antigen. Okay. If any antigen enter inside our body, means what will happen? Our antigen presenting cell will present that antigen via MHC class 2 to T helper cells. And these T helper cells will get activated and that will release some chemicals like cytokines. And these cytokines that will activate other immune cells and that will mount immune response and that will cause tissue damage. That is the type 4 hypersensitivity. Examples for type 4 hypersensitivity are poison ivy and poison oak, metals, example nickel, topical medication, symptoms of tuberculosis, symptoms of leprosy. We know that some people are allergic to some jewelry. The material, the metal that is used to make that particular jewelry, that is absorbable through the skin and that will cause type 4 hypersensitivity. Okay. This type 4 hypersensitivity reaction is first observed by Robert Koch. He only described this type 4 hypersensitivity reaction first time. And he observed that if individuals are infected with mycobacterium tuberculosis, that will develop some localized inflammatory response when they are injected with filtrate derived from mycobacterium. And he called that localized inflammatory reaction as tuberculin reaction. So Robert Koch is first described type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. So let's see the mechanism of type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. In type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, CD4 Th1 cells encounter certain types of antigen. They produce cytokines which induce a localized inflammatory reaction mediated by non-specific inflammatory cell, most prominently macrophages. So, in hypersensitivity reaction, CD4 T cells will encounter antigen that is presented by antigen presenting cells via MSC2, and that will produce this activated CD4 plus TH1 cells that will produce cytokines that will activate macrophages and other non-specific inflammatory cells, and that will cause tissue damage. Thus is type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. The antigens involved may be either intracellular pathogens such as Mycobacterium tuberculosis, herpes simplex virus, or contact antigens such as nickel salt, poison, IV, etc. So, examples for type 4 hypersensitivity antigens are intracellular pathogens or contact antigens. Intracellular pathogens like Mycobacterium tuberculosis, herpes simplex virus, etc. And contact antigens like nickel salt, poison ivy, etc. The reaction is accomplished in two phases, initial sensitization phase and the later effector phase. So there are two phases for type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. One is sensitization phase and other is effector phase. Okay. In the sensitization phase, the primary contact with the antigen is established. The antigen presenting cells in this case are macrophages, which secrete interleukin-1, which stimulate the proliferation of further CD4 plus T cells. We know that if any antigen get inside our body, what will happen? Our antigen presenting cells like macrophages that will engulf that antigen and that will present that antigen to T helper cells via MHC class 2. And these macrophages also produce some cytokines like interleukin-1 that will stimulate T helper cells, and T helper cells will get activated and differentiated into many T helper cells like T helper cell 1. And in the effector phase, a subsequent exposure to the same antigen induces the delayed type hypersensitivity response. So the second exposure of the same pathogen or the antigen that will cause delayed type hypersensitivity response by activating T helper cells. T helper cells means memory T helper cells. Cytokines such as interleukin-2 and interferon gamma is released from T helper cell 1 cell, which mediate the immune response activating macrophages and other non-specific inflammatory cells. So, upon the second exposure of the same antigen, this T helper cell 1 that will get activated and that will produce some cytokines like interleukin-2 and interferon gamma, and these cytokines that will activate macrophages and also other non-specific inflammatory cells and also cytotoxic T lymphocytes. This activated CD8 plus T cells, on other hand, destroy target cells on contact. We know that CD8 T cells, inside the cytotoxic T cells, granzymes and perforin is present. We already discussed that one. This perforin that will create, perforin and granzymes will secrete out, and this perforin will create pores on the surface of the target cell. Through this pore, granzymes will get inside and that will kill target cell by activating apoptosis. Whereas activated macrophages produce hydrolytic enzyme, and on presentation with certain intracellular pathogen, transform into multinucleated gene cells. So here macrophages are the major effector cells of delayed type hypersensitivity. These cytokines that is produced by T helper cells 1 that will induce monocyte that is present in the blood vessel to migrate into the tissue, and thus monocyte that will differentiate into activated macrophages. The phagocytic activity as well as the lytic enzyme. We know that these macrophages are phagocytic cells and also that will produce some chemicals like cytokines. So phagocytic activity as well as the lytic enzyme production from the macrophages in the area of infection lead to non-specific destruction of the cell. Sometimes these macrophages that will also form multinucleate giant cells, that means granuloma. This granuloma develops when continuous activation of macrophages these macrophages will adhere together to form multinucleate giant cells called a granuloma. This granuloma that will produce high concentration of lytic enzyme that will destroy surrounding tissue. Okay, so the overreaction of the helper T cell and overproduction of cytokines damage tissue, cause inflammation and cell death. That is type 4 hypersensitivity. One example for type 4 hypersensitivity is contact dermatitis or contact hypersensitivity. That is occurs after sensitization with simple chemicals, example nickel, formaldehyde and plant materials like poison ivy, some cosmetic, soaps and other substances. The small materials enter the skin and acting as haptans attach to body protein which induce cell mediated hypersensitivity particularly in the skin. On subsequent exposure to the agent, the sensitized person develops erythema, itching, vesication, eczema or necrosis of the skin within 12 to 48 hours. So these chemicals like nickel, formaldehyde, poison ivy, they are very simple chemicals. Most of these substances are small molecules that can complex with our body protein. That will complex with our body protein to form haptans. Okay. And our antigen presenting cells that will present this hapten to our T helper cells. T helper cells will get activated and that will differentiate to produce many helper cells like memory T helper cells. So this Th1 cells will get sensitized. On the second exposure of the same pathogen, that will cause type 4 hypersensitivity or cell mediated hypersensitivity. This T helper cell 1 will produce cytokines that will activate other cells like macrophages and also non-specific inflammatory cells, cytotoxic T cells like that, and that will cause tissue damage by producing chemical substance or lytic enzymes. And this sensitized person that will develop symptoms like erythema, itching, vesication, eczema, necrosis, etc. And that will take 12 to 48 hours after antigen exposure. That means that is delayed type hypersensitivity. That will take at least 12 to 48 hours after the antigen exposure. Okay. That is contact hypersensitivity or contact dermatitis. So, type 4 hypersensitivity reaction involves cell mediated branch of immune system, antigen activation of sensitized T helper cell 1 that will release various cytokines that will cause macrophages to accumulate and become activated, and the net effect of the activation of macrophages is to release lytic enzyme that will cause localized tissue damage. So that is type 4 hypersensitivity. So here I am winding up this video. For daily quiz and MCQ discussion, please join our Telegram channel. And if you like this video and find it helpful, please click the like button, share with your friends, and also subscribe this channel to get more videos like this. Keep learning. Thank you.